Hey, greetings, y'all. Trinity Biker 24. And tonight's moto vlog, tonight's moto vlog will be about, I guess, the common misconceptions of different states and stereotypes of different states. Recently, I saw that there was a comment on one of Chris Caliente's videos where I think the guy's name is Mike Harrison. I think he was trying to compare Arkansas or trying to stereotype Arkansas with people that use meth and also people that run moonshine. As far as I know, that is a stereotype. It is a stereotype that is perpetrated by the mainstream media, who like to stereotype places that they've never been to. Now, this is the mainstream media, not talking local media, because, well, it's local. Now, people like to make stereotypical assumptions. That's what it is, and preconceptions. And that's simply not true. I have lived in Arkansas off and on all of my life. I've also lived in California. Now, I can tell you this, that Arkansas is not like that. Arkansas, as you probably have seen from some of my Arkansas tours video, is a very beautiful state. It really is. And granted, you got a whole lot of curves, a whole lot of switchbacks here. And especially, there's a run, and I checked this out in the Harrison Motorcycling Guide of the Ozarks. I think it's called Motorcycling Guide of the Ozarks. And I'll put a link in this video in the description box where you all can see it. But the longest route is called the Lost Mine Run. Now, this is about 5 hours and 7 minutes from Harrison. Now, for me, it would take another hour and a half. So there's about 6 hours and 37 minutes to get there, and then another hour and a half to get home. So now we're looking at 7, maybe 8 hours total. But this thing has over 835, I think it's 835, scenic curves. So we're talking a lot of scenic curves. And as Memphis Mike found out, the Arkansas Dragon is quite a challenge. We call it the Jasper Disaster. And that's also a route in that booklet. Now, there is more roads here than you can probably shake a stick at. And each one of them provides a challenge. Even going up to Eureka Springs is a challenge. So if you all have a motorcycle, and most of my subscribers do, I'd say come to Arkansas. Challenge yourself. Challenge yourself with all these roads. Even the roads that are long and twisty, and some of them are, well, they're very pretty going along the route, like going from Russellville to going from Russellville to the Crater of Diamonds. And I've got a video on that. That's also in my Arkansas Tours video. But getting back to the point, people seem to think that Arkansas, aside from the Clintons, that that were the governor of Arkansas at one time, and then Bill became president, and they did a lot of evil stuff, ranging from, as you all have heard with Hillary and her email scandal, ranging from that and other things like her and her mafia buddies, and how they killed Vince Foster and other people. I mean, the list grows and grows, especially the guy from the DNC chairman. So they kill him off because of WikiLeaks. So basically, these people are insane. Now, that does not mean that all of Arkansas is like that. All of Arkansas is like how they support Hillary. That's not the case, because of the fact that, well, Arkansas has a Republican governor now. They have mostly, it's Republican state seat. There's very little Democrats. But that's beside the point. Now, Arkansas is a very beautiful state. But people have this common misconception, thanks to the mainstream media, that all we do here is we smoke meth and drink moonshine. That's a bunch of bull beep, because not everybody here does that. But that's like saying that, well, that's like saying New York is a bunch of overly angry people who get upset at the most slightest thing that you talk about. Or they're like people from Seinfeld, where that was just a show. That's not true. But yet people have this common misconception of it. So, does that mean that New York is a bunch of overly angry people? I don't think so. I mean, look at, for instance, DeFobra. Is he angry? No. He lives in New York. Crazy cool New Yorker. Is he like that? No, he's not like that. Those are just a few samples. Now, then, of course, you've got all these other ones, like California. Oh, God, California. I used to live there. So, I mean, is California just a state that's going to fall into the ocean because of all the earthquakes and fires? No, I don't think so. Granted, California has the San Andreas Fault, and then, of course, you got all those fires out there right now, and then of course you got LA, which if it wasn't for people like Officer Rob, it would probably be even more of a problem. But that's also a common misconception. It's also a common misconception that, I mean, just look at what happened when I went down to Little Rock. That Little Rock is a bad place. Granted, it is a big city. And there will be crime. But there will be crime in every part of this nation. And what has happened recently ought to be proof of that. Milwaukee bought, or not Boston, all the other cities, Milwaukee, for instance, and then, of course, you got Chicago, and then, of course, there's Ferguson, and all of this stuff that pretty much is based on conjecture. And then, of course, you got the media that overly does everything. They overly expose everything. And then they create the stereotype. Now, that is just a few examples. Now, what about other countries? Like, let's say, for instance, Russia. There's a country that they've got people over there that do a lot of stuff like, well, the live map helmet, for instance. But is that guy a jerk? Does that guy probably drink vodka and do all the other sort of stereotypical things? Probably not. He's probably got his own life, and he's probably got a lot of stuff that he's going on in his life. But do we have to stereotype the whole country that way? No. So it's like here in the United States, are all people bad? No. It's just the dumb idiot politicians that we have to deal with. But there are other examples. I mean, look at Australia. I mean, Australia is a beautiful country. But people have this common misconception of Australia, ranging from, well, it's this or it's that, but it's really not. We all have to start looking at these stupid stereotypes and really look at it, because even places like Tehran, Iran, which those guys, I am a subscriber from Tehran. And is he a crazy person? No, not according to his vlogs. Iraq, are they a bunch of crazy people? No. It's all a matter of conception, or not conception, but perception and stereotype. But we all have to get along here. Cannot be a bunch of idiots that go around and stereotype a state or a country based upon one or two things. We have to start looking at the bigger picture. We're all on this big old spinning blue globe. We all have to get along. We cannot keep doing this with our petty differences. But anyway, that's really all I've got for you tonight. I'm gonna go inside and get ready to go to work in about a couple hours. Anyway, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I will talk to you all later. I am on my 2014 Honda CTX 1300 Deluxe motorcycle, and I will talk to you all later.